And this is breaking news coming in from Bihar's Munger district. A 3-year-old girl fell in an open borewell. This incident took place when the toddler was playing last evening. We're given to understand that it is a 110-foot borewell. The NDRF teams have reached the spot and they have been, in fact, trying to rescue the 3-year-old girl. The rescue operations are currently underway. The police, the NDRF team, all are at the spot trying to rescue the girl.
सबसे ज्यादा परेशानी है कि उसका हम लोग उसमें पूरा रेस्पिरेटरी चैनल जो उसका पूरा क्लियर रखें जी जो इतनी नीचे सुरंग में गिरी है लेकिन बहुत सारा मिट्टी वगैरह उसका फेस पर लगा हुआ है बाल के ऊपर है कि नाक सुराख से नॉस्ट्रिल से बंद नहीं हो अच्छी तरह सांस ले सके और उसके बाकी उसकी जो और भी ट्रीटमेंट है हम लोग उसको आगे कैरी आउट
आने वाले समय लड़की के लिए क्रिटिकल होगा हेल्थ के दृष्टि से
क्रिटिकल इन द सेंस जिस समय हम लोग निकालेंगे उसी समय उसका हम लोग एसेस कर पाएंगे कितना क्रिटिकल है.
So the rescue operation is currently underway. Let's get an update from Shyam Sundar, who's joining us on the phone line. Shyam, tell us what's happening there.
Well, as of now, rescue operations are underway, and SDRF, the state disaster relief force, and the district administrations are carrying out rescue operations. But let me tell you that this incident happened last evening when this 3-year-old girl, Sana, she was playing at the house, and all of a sudden, she fell in that open borewell which was dug there. Now, it's been said that this was a 110-foot borewell that was being dug, but she's been stuck at 45 feet, and that is what the rescue operators have been saying. Now, meanwhile, looking at the health facilities, doctors have been stationed there, oxygen supply is being facilitated, and even CCTV cameras have been installed to monitor the activities of the little child. Now, it's been more than 12 hours, and certainly it is very critical. The rescue operators even say that the next few hours will be very critical, but as of now, a parallel hole has been dug there, and even it's been said that army jawans from Ranchi cantonment have also been called in, and they are also going to reach Munger very soon.
All right, Shyam Sundar, thanks for getting us the latest there. Of course, we'll continue taking updates. Rescue operations currently underway, as Shyam is telling us. The police and the NDRF teams at the spot trying to rescue the girl. Remember, it's a 110-foot borewell where the girl had fallen in last evening. And those are the visuals of the rescue operations that are taking place. At the moment, they are currently underway since last evening. We're given to understand that the NDRF team and the police team reached quickly after this incident took place. Now, what the initial details that are emerging at the moment are that this girl was playing around this borewell. It was an open borewell, 110 feet deep. Clearly a challenging task ahead there for the NDRF teams. There who are trying to rescue the girl. Shyam, also take us through. All right, Shyam joining us now on the phone line once again. Shyam, also take us through what are the challenges that are being faced by the rescue team. It's already been a couple of hours, more than 12 hours you're given to understand, since the girl fell into this borewell. Take us through the challenges that are being facing the rescue teams who are trying to rescue the girl.
Well, it's been more than 12 hours. It was said that last evening the girl was playing inside a house and this borewell was dug inside her grandfather's house where she had come along with her mother. And since she was a small child, 3-year-old child, so certainly the rescue operators and the doctors are monitoring her very minutely. Now, it was being said that she was playing all alone and all of a sudden she fell in this borewell which was being dug in her grandfather's house. And after which the family members tried to take her out, but when they failed, then they had informed the district administration, after which the district administration arrived at the location along with doctors and then they tried to take her out, but when they failed, then they called the state disaster relief force jawans, and since yesterday itself, last evening itself, the rescue operations are underway. Now, meanwhile, even the army has been contacted, because we all know since the army jawans are have technology with them, so certainly they are coming with some equipments and that they'll try to rescue the girl. But as of now, the doctors, they're present clearly saying that it is a very critical situation for the girl now, because it's been more than 13 to 14 hours. And certainly the doctors are trying to pump in oxygen. They have sent in a bladder also so that the girl can sit on it, because since she's a very small child. But as of now, when we spoke to the doctors and the rescue operators, they clearly said that they can hear the noise of the girl. The girl has been crying inside. So this means that the girl is still alive. Doctors clearly saying that the next few hours would be very critical for the girl child.
All right, so doctors also present there at the spot. They're trying to pump in the oxygen, but clearly since this has taken place 12 hours ago, the next few hours are going to be very critical, Shyam, as you're telling us. What we also understand by what Shyam is telling us is that the army has also now been reached out to, and the army teams are also expected to come in and help the NDRF teams who are trying to rescue the girl. This happened, of course, last evening, as we are telling you, where the girl was playing all alone near the borewell. She fell in. There were attempts made by the family to pull her out, but after having to fail to rescue her out, police teams were contacted. The NDRF team reached at the spot, but at the moment, efforts are now being made to pull the girl out. It's a 110 feet borewell that we're looking at. So challenging task ahead there. So far, no headway has been made. Shyam continues to be with us to give us more inputs. Shyam, do we know more about why was this borewell left open? And what do the eyewitnesses say? Was there anybody around when she fell into that borewell? And what does the family allege at this point? And so let's once again listen in to Rakesh Kumar Sinha, who's the deputy superintendent. Let's listen in to what he had to say.
सबसे ज़्यादा परेशानी है कि उसका हम लोग उसमें पूरा रेस्पिरेटरी चैनल जो उसका पूरा क्लियर रखें कि जितनी नीचे सुरंग में गिरी है लेकिन बहुत सारा मिट्टी वगैरह उसका फेस पर लगा हुआ है बाल के ऊपर है कि नाक सुराख से नॉस्ट्रिल से बंद नहीं हो अच्छी तरह सांस ले सके और उसके बाकी उसकी जो और भी ट्रीटमेंट है हम लोग उसको आगे कैरी आउट
आने वाले समय लड़की के लिए क्रिटिकल होगा हेल्थ के दृष्टि से
क्रिटिकल इन द सेंस जिस समय हम लोग निकालेंगे उसी समय उसका हम लोग एसेस कर पाएंगे कितना क्रिटिकल है.
So this is an incident that's coming to light from Bihar's Munger district. A three-year-old girl has fallen in a 110-feet borewell. The girl is reportedly stuck inside the borewell, and what we're given to understand that her condition is all right at the moment, as the doctors team which are present there at the spot are saying that they can hear the girl crying. But as is being reported, the next few hours are going to be critical, because it's already been over 12 hours since this three-year-old girl fell in that 110 feet deep borewell. The incident occurred last evening. It's been over 12 hours. There were initial attempts made by the family to pull the girl out, but after many failed attempts, the family reached out to the police team. The NDRF teams were also called in. We also given to understand that the army has also been called in to assist the NDRF teams. Shyam continues to be with us. Shyam, if you could also give us an update as to why was this borewell left open? What is the family alleging?
Family clearly saying that the borewell was dug yesterday itself, as it was being dug inside the courtyard of the house. And last evening when it got dark, the process had come to a stop, and after which the borewell was not covered. That is what has been predicted. But as a family, not saying many things, because certainly at the moment they want that little girl to be rescued. So certainly the family is at fault, because why was the borewell open and then there was a small child in it? They should have taken care of it. But certainly after Sana, when she was playing all alone in the courtyard, she fell in this borewell. And then the family made several attempts to take her out, but after failed attempts, they contacted the district administration and the police station, after which rescue operations started by the district administration, and then they called in the local NDRF and the jawans, after which NDRF jawans came with equipment, and the rescue operations started last evening itself. But since it was a very narrow pool, that is what is being said, certainly the NDRF jawans are facing certain problems in taking her out, and that is the reason why even the army from the Ranchi cantonment have been called in, because since we all know that the army is specialized in doing such things, so certainly the army jawans have been called in, and very soon it seems that the army jawans from Ranchi will be reaching there very soon. But certainly the movement of the little child is being monitored with the help of CCTV cameras. The doctors are keeping a tab on her. The doctors clearly say that as of now, movement is being seen. The girl is also crying inside. So certainly doctors have pumped in oxygen, and they've also sent in a bladder so that the girl can sit on it. So certainly it's been said that the next few hours would be very critical, and very soon the army jawans are also going to reach. So certainly everyone is hopeful that the girl would be rescued safely.
All right, Shamsundar, thanks for getting us those inputs there. The rescue operation is currently underway. The army has also been called in. The movement of the girl child is being monitored through a CCTV camera. Oxygen is being pumped in, but as is being seen, the next few hours is going to be critical, because it's already been over 12 hours since the girl fell into this deep borewell. We'll continue taking updates from Shamsundar through the course of the day. Of course, one hopes that the rescue takes place as soon as possible there.